Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. This is GenZee Podcast Team 4. Welcome to our very last podcast. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Sun Chuen from Selangor, currently studying in Xiamen University Malaysia, majoring in artificial intelligence. I will be the moderator for today's podcast, and today we will be mainly discussing cyberbullying. Members, could you give a brief introduction about yourself?
Hello everyone, my name is Ronnie Ngen. You guys can call me Ronnie, and I'm 19 years old and I come from Selangor. I'm currently a year one finance student in Xiamen University, Malaysia.
Hey everyone, my name is Jun Hong, or you can call me Dylan, and I'm 17 years old this year. And I come from Muar, Johor. And also, I'm majoring in finance this year in Xiamen University, Malaysia.
Hi guys, I'm Shin. I'm from Selangor and currently studying International Business Management program in Xiamen University.
Hello, my name is Ming Hao. I'm 19 years old and I'm now living in Johor. I'm a year one artificial intelligence student at Xiamen University in Malaysia.
Hey everyone, I'm Stephen Lai from Penang. I'm 19 years old and my major course is international business. I'm glad to be the speaker in this podcast.
Hi. I'm Jia Chen and I'm studying artificial intelligence at Xiamen University, Malaysia. I'm 19 years old and I come from Penang.
Alright, so everyone roughly knows what cyberbullying is, but I don't really get what cyberbullying is. So can any of you explain more about cyberbullying?
Yeah, of course. I will explain the word cyberbullying. So for me, cyberbullying is like we try to bully someone by using digital communication tools, for example, the internet, cell phones, and computers, or something like that. It usually takes place on social media, but sometimes it also happens on the messaging and gaming platforms like streaming. Cyberbullying is a behavior that more on intentionally and keeps on repeating the same thing for the purpose of scaring, angering, or shaming someone that who are targeted. Like sharing personal or private negative information about someone else, causing embarrassment or humiliation will be the examples of cyberbullying. Yeah.
Yeah, actually, cyberbullying also can occur from lies and false accusations, jealousy, toxic over online games, and etc. And then, so I do research, right, I found that cyberbullying also has its own unique concerns. It can be persistent, permanent, and hard to notice. So, for the first persistent, it represents some of the social platforms that offers abilities to immediately and continuously communicate 24 hours a day. And then the second one's permanence is like the most information communicated is permanent and public, if not reported, it will not be removed. And then the last one is the hard to notice. We can see that it is because of teachers and parents may not overhear or see cyberbullying taking place, and it is hardest to recognize.
So basically, from what I've heard just now, so I think cyberbullying is the use of gadgets to mirror the way a person would be bullied in real life. I wonder what actually causes cyberbullying and why would people get cyberbullied?
Okay, in my opinion, I think that lack of empathy is judged as a factor of cyberbullying. As a result, The cyberbullies cannot see the pain that they cause to their victim and also cannot imagine that the turmoil they put to their victim through. This is because they don't believe that the happening of cyberbullying is a big deal and they haven't seen the pain that they cause to their victim. Therefore, they will feel little or no remorse for their action. Not only that, they will also feel happy when bullying someone. Next, I think the second factor of cyberbullying should be the burden become pain. How to say burden will become pain? As we know, most of the bullies are truth-free or they have nothing to do. So they would like to get a shot of kick out of the targeting through online. For example, they will treat cyberbullying as an entertainment to add some excitement and drama to their life. This is because cyberbullying is the easiest way to bully someone. They can just type back a reply or just log in on to redirect the messages. For my last point is, the people who are choosing to bully someone via online is because their lack of attention or supervision from their parents. They cannot show their bad emotion to others because they are too lonely. So they have no choice to release their bad mood to their victim. As a result, the bullies can use their only sources of entertainment and a platform, which is the internet, for getting attention from their parents. That's all.
I agree with what Steven say. In my mind, I think there's still a lot of factors that can cause cyberbullying. One of them is people commonly believe that they will not be caught because they are posting comments or post anonymously in the internet. This makes it to be difficult to figure out who are they or to locate where they live in. Even though some of the users normally will provide the basic information about themselves on the internet, but they can provide inaccurate information too. This shows that internet gives the users the impression that they are safe and away from the punishments of the laws. Thus, this causes cyberbullying to occur frequently. Other than that, I think people often overestimate their abilities or underestimate the difficulty of their achievements or stuff and criticize others with some rude words, which can cause cyberbullying. In real life, they have the idea that they can complete the stuff which requires high skill easily or achieve a higher achievement than someone who they criticize. They then will consider that the difficulty to achieve their achievement. As an instance, many cyberbullying occurs to the gaming streamers, artists, and competitive players due to some of their bad performance in their game, movies, or competitions. That's all for me.
I think parents have to do something. You know, parents play a big role in giving proper instructions to their children. And I suggest parents monitor their children's online activity and they should teach their children to think before they speak so that the cases of cyberbullying can be lowered. You know, there are a lot of cyberbullying cases happening in the world. Do you guys know about Sully's case? She's like one of the most iconic cases of cyberbullying.
Not so sure, but I think I have heard her name before.
Yeah, I know about the case. I was once a fan. So basically, Sully is one of the members from FX, from a girl, K-pop girl crawl FX that debuted in 2009. And Sully was just her stage name only lah. And her real name is Choi Jinri. But like, it's like around after five or six years, I think, like around 2015, she left the group and continued focus on her acting career.
Oh yeah, I heard it before. If I'm not mistaken, wasn't she passed away already like a few years ago?
Yeah, true. That was unfortunate. She passed away like 2 years ago. All of this would happen after she left a group because she received a lot of malicious and negative comments from the netizens whenever she posts something on her Instagram. I remember I saw some comments where they said she took some drugs, she's untalented, and so on. And basically, the whole comment section is too toxic already. And the worst part is, since she's a famous idol, there's a lot of netizens even scrutinized about her body and her behavior. Yeah, so because of all of these comments from netizens, which we call cyberbullying, Suli took her own life by hanging herself on the second floor on her own house. According to NBC News, Suli's manager reported that he visited Suli's house when she was not able to reach her. But when he reached her house, he found out that she was already dead. And before this incident happened, her manager also mentioned that she is suffering from depression too.
Really feel bad for her.
I know, right? Life is so unpredictable.
Yeah. So actually, cyberbullying is really terrible. Even someone believes a man's post, chances are it's still available in some form, such as in a screenshot or share text message. What is the most terrifying is those targets by cyberbullies often doesn't know who is bullying them, so they often have no ways to bring it to an end.
There's another cyberbullying case that I know that happened in Malaysia. This case is about a local citizen of Malaysia, Divya Rajendran, who comes from an Indian family from Bukit Tengah, Penang. She committed suicide and was found dead at his home. This incident of cyberbullying happened during last year's May, and she was only at the age of 20. Everything started when a Facebook page named Joker Oruvan posted a few TikTok videos, which the content was about Divya and her colleague, who appears to be in Bangladeshi. They were dancing and reenacting to a scene from a Hindi song. Surprisingly, the comments down the post were filled with hatred and laughing at her. All sorts of comments which were disrespectful and indecent. They ridiculed her for supposedly dating a foreigner and suggested that she was an easy character. All of this was inappropriate and were not true. Eventually, those comments drove her to attempt to suicide.
Wow, I think this is really unacceptable. I really feels bad for us, yeah.
Yellow, all of this has to stop.
Yes, she even mentioned that in her suicide note, because it spoke her name and her family's name, so she decided to commit suicide. Divya's sister also mentioned that she did not suffer from cyberbullying, but people also started to recognize her from the videos. Despite being reported and demanded to take down the video, the admin of the page ignored until the incident of Divya's death.
It's kind of sad to hear that people die because of bully. And what I want to say is, this thing, like what you have said earlier, this thing should stop. And after listening to the cases, we shall move on to the next part, which is a sharing session. And now, I would like to invite the guests to this call. All right, guys, it's story time. And we are glad to have two guests joining us today. And both of them are victims of cyberbullying. I would like to name them as guest one and guest two to keep their personal information confidential. And let's invite them to share their story now. Hello, guest one and guest two.
Hello.
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 Can sacrifice your precious time joining us today. Would you like to tell us about your experience being a victim of cyberbullying, guest one?
Yeah, sure. Before I became a slender basketball player, I was attacked by a lot of people. This happened back in 2015. We had a basketball competition, but the competition was live streamed in various social media. Competition was one of the big events in my life. Me and my teammate were prepared and everyone put their hope on us. During the competition match, I made a small mistake, which is I didn't pass the ball well, and the opponent grabbed the chance and scored on us. We were so close to winning the championship. Because of that small mistake, we lost in the finals. Everyone started to insult and attack me on social media after the game. I had no choice but to stay away from the comments. I remember so well that they said their grandparents can play better than me. And that's hurt my ego. I was depressed and nearly gave up basketball. Luckily, my parents supported me throughout the hard times. Because of them, I am now representing Selangor and competing with other states in basketball. Everyone started to support me lately. There are always people who want to belittle me, but that doesn't affect me anymore because I'm built different now. I think that's all for me. Yeah. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Yaswan. Glad to hear that you have overcame. Glad to hear that you are coming back strong. And wish you all the best in the future. Guess what? Do you have anything that you want to tell the audience?
I think cyberbullying is a silent killer, and words can hurt for everyone. Yeah.
Okay, thank you for the advice. Members, do you have anything that you guys want to say?
It's nice to hear that you have come back strong, and it's good to hear that.
All right, now we shall listen to guest two's story. Guest two, you may start sharing now.
Hello, everyone. I was famous for playing this game called CSGO because I posted my gameplay on social media and everyone wanted me to stream my gameplay. So I started streaming my game on a streaming platform called Twitch. There was 1 month where I wasn't in a good form due to some personal reason. So I played badly that month. That was the month that I had the most viewers. Because of the bad performance, the viewers gave toxic comments in the chat box. They insulted me so badly until I quit streaming. I'm glad that I have great teammates supporting me when I am in a bad state. I changed my game ID and I started all over again. I trained with my teammates day and night without streaming the gameplay. 3 years later, me and my teammates joined an international CSGO competition. The audience saw me and they insulted me again. But I wasn't affected by them because I was in my prime. I proved them wrong by getting MVP in the competition. Haters couldn't attack me because my performance was perfect. After this competition, I have gained confidence and people start to admire me.
All right. That was interesting, guess two. Okay, thank you, guess two. What I want to say is, come on, netizens. Please think before you say. Like what guess one said earlier, words can hurt, okay? Words and hearts should be handled with care. You know, for words when spoken and hearts when broken are the hardest things to repair. Please put yourself in someone else's shoes. The way you talk really, really hurts. I hope that both of the guests' experience can help those who are suffering from cyberbullying. You know, cyberbullying is horrendous. It's so terrifying that it could make a person kiseo. Okay, we urge you to think before you express your thoughts, because cyberbullying is a silent killer. Be kind, be polite. Lastly, we have our group slogan. Put some color in somebody's life today. Don't be a bully. Before we end this podcast, we would like to express our gratitude to the audiences. Our project has come to an end. Thank you for supporting us in our community service project. Bye-bye.
On the first page of our
story. Thank you.
Thank you. The future seemed so bright.
Bye-bye.
Then the saint turned
bye-bye.
So
bye-bye.
Evil.
Bye-bye.
I don't know why I'm still surprised. Even angels have their wicked schemes. But you'll always be my hero, even though you've lost your mind. Just gonna stand there and watch me burn. But that's all I know.
mean that you...
Um.